For a standard normal distribution, we want to find c such that the probability of z being less than c equals 0.614. Notice how here we have the probability of z being less than c, and therefore, if we find the z-score on the standard normal distribution, the area to the left of that z-score would be the same as this probability, 0.614. And since this value is greater than 0.5, we should recognize that the z-score will be positive, since when z is 0, the data value is the mean, the probability to the left would be 50%, and the probability to the right would be 50%. So if the probability to the left is 0.614, let's say the z-score is maybe somewhere in here, where the z-score equals c, then the probability of z being less than c would be the same as the area to the left, which we know is 0.614. So this area to the left, which is the same as the probability to the left, is 0.614. So now to find the value of c, or the z-score, that satisfies this probability, we can now use the inverse norm feature on the TI84 graphing calculator. Normally, when using the inverse norm feature, we enter the probability to the left, comma the mean, comma the standard deviation. But in our case, since we're working with the standard normal distribution, and we're looking for a z-score, we can leave off mu and sigma. When we leave these off, mu equals 0 and sigma equals 1, which are the correct values for the standard normal distribution. Which means to find this z-score, or the value of c, we'll first press second vars for the distribution menu. Then we'll select option 3 for inverse norm. And now we'll just enter the area, or probability, to the left, which we know is 0.614. Close parenthesis and enter. And this gives us our value of c, or the z-score, such that the probability of z being less than this value is equal to 0.614. So rounded to 4 decimal places, c would be approximately 0.2898. I hope you found this helpful.